Later on, I've been hearing a lot of things about mental health crisis mm-hmm. out here in California, especially when it comes to kids. Mm-hmm. Do you have anything that you can tell me about that?
Yeah, there is, in my opinion, it's a mental health crisis. I believe it's greater than children, but how it specifically affects more children, percentage-wise, is when the pandemic started, and then in California, the schools were closed and stayed closed. And it was very, not a lot of schools or parents had options that they could send their kids to school part-time. So again, their whole developmental years, if you think about it, whether they were in first grade or seventh grade or high school, like again, if you think back to your growing up, yeah. like to be locked in a house somewhere. And again, that's unhealthy for human beings. Again, because for human beings, you know,
social
connection with other mm-hmm. people. But with kids, they're still growing, they're still developing. Mm-hmm. And even if you think to the earliest like psychological experiments about, I don't know if you've ever heard of the experiment, like when a little baby's gazing into its mother's eyes, again, how that connection, that secure bond is built. So again, that the baby later learns that they could walk so far and look back and maybe run to the mother, or at a certain point could be on its own. So when kids are growing up, they're learning these things, like how to feel secure, how to have confidence, you know, what they should stay away from. And again, it happens in the school environment mm-hmm. where, again, kids have fights, there's problems. But again, they learn, they develop. Mm-hmm. And again, how to feel secure. So now you have this whole, you know, 6-year-olds to 18-year-olds who their most important years that they lost something. They don't not only put away, they're like, they lost what they know is like the most important years of their life that they hear everybody else talking about. Oh, when I had graduated, or when I started high school, or when I was in the drama class, or, you know, when I applied to college, all these things have just been on hold.
Would you say that also kids are mostly affected by all the anxiety and the depression as well, or it's just something what is very typical for adults?
No, I would say with the kids that, and again, I have some adolescent clients, quite a few, that it's affected them to a greater degree. If you think sort of their structure, their frame of reference, their safety and security in the world, that all that has not been formed in a way it would have been. So again, their sense of trust, you know, this feelings of like danger or fear, which anxiety is, mm-hmm. or depression, which is just the opposite of anxiety, which is like shutting down because sort of the energy has been constricted. So again, the way I've kind of viewed the teen clients is that the pandemic and the closure of the school is actually a big adjustment. Mm-hmm. It's called an adjustment because what that means is something happened in the life, like a move, if you move out of the country, or if your parents got divorced, mm-hmm. exactly. So an adjustment could be a trigger for something, mm-hmm. but it's actually the adjustment disorder that has symptoms. Yeah. So I see, yes, a lot of anxiety, a lot of depression, and again, maybe the adjustment disorder. So there is a reason behind it, which would, in my opinion, the pandemic, which I think a lot of people would agree, was a major adjustment for these, mm-hmm. for this teen population in particular we're talking about, our kids. And it's just too big of an adjustment to really be healthy enough.
Yeah, to handle it like with no problems.
Yeah, because you have to think it affected everything. Kids couldn't play sports. Mm-hmm. I mean, kids couldn't have after-school activities.
Well, they couldn't do it out here. But for example, like when I was in Florida, I told you like everything is open for over a year. So it didn't affect them at all. They go to school and they just live normally. Just out here, you know, everything was closed and so on. Do you think that this also can make in future a big difference within a people? That there's a states who just remain open and didn't do anything different pretty much on, like, of course they did something, but they didn't do it that hard way like they do it out here or let's say in Europe. Do you think that later on in life, let's say 20 years from now, even this can be like create some certain conflict or something?
Yeah, I think absolutely. And I think that's been sort of played out in the individual states and even in the political systems, that the longer the pandemic went on and the longer the schools were closed, again, people started to think, okay, is somebody, is a kid getting coronavirus, what is the risk of that? Mm-hmm. And people started to think, well, there isn't
what is
that
the,
much risk. Yeah. The cost gain, the gain loss benefit.
Mm-hmm.
So again, people started to think, well, it makes sense for kids to be in school. That's what the CDC says.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have other school districts, again, who entered now into the politics of it.
Mm-hmm.
So absolutely, I think the kids have been put in California have been put into an extreme disadvantage, mm-hmm. which is, again, going to, you're already seeing, you can see statistically, you know, more teen depression, more teen suicide, more drug abuse.
Teen suicide?
In the States, yeah. Yeah, it's very, that's a crisis.
What the hell?